And I fix my hope upon you, Jesus. You're the author and finisher of my faith. I will trust in you all the days of my life, and I'm gonna reach to my home.
Heavenly Father, we come before you this Trinity Sunday, worshiping and glorifying your holy name for the way you have been with us, Lord, this year. As we are nearing the middle of this year, Lord, we ask you to be with us throughout this day and throughout this service in our family altars. How do we pray, Father, that you may lead levered others who will be ministering to us this morning? We pray that, believing and trusting in Jesus' name. Amen.
The pastoral greetings and the entire Christian community of Gedaga Parish, Emmanuel Church Gedaga, St. Paul's Church Kebum, and to all our diaspora Christians and all the friends of our parish and our Christians. We thank God for you when we remember how committed you have been to serving the Lord in your family altars all the way through. And we thank God for your prayers, the way you've been supporting the ministry, and even now as we near getting back to the sanctuaries, we will forever remember and be grateful to God and to all of you for your services. Even now, we want to invite you to our services immediately. The church is open and the Lord will do us good. May the Lord bless you as you do your family altars. Today, the Trinity Sunday. God bless you and have a blessed time.
I'm in the race, moving on to your Father.
Lord Jesus, we bow before your throne. As your Holy Spirit prepares to understand thy word, we beseech your guidance, patience, as thy Holy Spirit warn us and teach us where we are supposed to. We commit thy servant, Reverend Dada, as he expound thy words, for we do pray this in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Praise God. We want to thank God this morning for the very privilege and honor of sitting at the feet of the Lord and hearing his word. My name is Reverend Arthur Minor, and I thank God for having saved me and called me to his ministry. Today, the Trinity Sunday, we are going to discuss on the theme, Go and Make Disciples of All Nations. In the book of Matthew, chapter number 28 and verse 19, therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you, and surely I am with you always to the end of the time. This is what we got at the Lord's great commission. And Jesus had called the disciples, and from the onset had made it clear to them they were to be fishers of men. They were to continue the message that he had brought. And Jesus calls and prepares people for the ministry. He disciples us so that he can later invite us and send us to be disciples. And all of us have potential to be witnesses. And indeed, in the book of Acts, chapter number 32, chapter 2 and verse 32, we are all called to be witnesses of what Jesus has done in our lives. Jesus did and said, and he demonstrated the way he would want us to carry the holistic ministry to the whole person. Jesus shared his life with the disciples. Today, God has called us that he may prepare us to be change agents wherever he has placed us. We, like the disciples, are called to go through the three phases of preparation. And in the book of Matthew, chapter number 4 and verse 19, come and see. And in summary, we see three invitations. Come and see. Jesus invited the disciples to observe him and his priorities. He invited them to evaluate him and also evaluate themselves in the light of what he was doing. He was a role model. And in the book of Philippians 2 and verse 8, Jesus humbled himself to the point of death. And so one of the lessons we are to come and see is Jesus' humility. Number two of the invitation, come and follow me. Jesus asked for a greater commitment than what they were doing before when they were fishing. They were to do more than observe. They were to be with him. They were to observe what he was doing. They were to associate with him. And number three, the third invitation, come and be with him, with me. For 3 years, they had companionship with Jesus. They experienced Jesus as he taught, as he traveled. He prayed and taught them how to pray. He ate with the sinners indiscriminately. He healed the sick. He raised the dead. The whole gospel to the whole man. Every single person had the opportunity to hear and experience the love of God through Jesus Christ, who told them and demonstrated, I came to heal the sick and even they that were lost. I came to preach good news to the poor. I came to set the captives free. I came to restore sight to they that were blind. And I came to free the oppressed. And I came to declare the time of the Lord's favor. That's what we look in the book of Luke, chapter 4, 18 to 19. That Jesus comes and targets everybody. The whole gospel for which man has been prepared to go and present. The disciples experienced the consistency of what Jesus was teaching. Indeed, he was a practical teacher in all he did. He walked, he talked in all what he was saying and what he was doing. Therefore, having been in the school of Jesus, they now are prepared for the ministry, the Great Commission, which we see as fourfold. And we are a command to go and do the same. Number one, go and make disciples. This applies to all believers. Every one of us is blessed with different giftings and are to share our lives with the hearers. We go where the people are. We don't wait for them to come where we are. Number two, teach. It is to make disciples. And in the book of Matthew 13 and 52, we are to bring all the teachings, both the Old and the New Testament. And in the, again, number three, baptize those who repent and believe. Whereas this is to be done, the baptism by they that are specifically called and prepared to do the same. The ministry of preparing and calling them and making people convicted that they want to know the Lord and be baptized. It is for all of us. And number four, teaching and preaching. They were to teach on the truth of good news as well as lead them to the need to repent and to be forgiven of their sins. This is by sharing the word and also by showing the word and also by teaching the word. And number four, by serving the word. This is what we Christians are called by God to be prepared and to go and do. Every opportunity is to be used to go out of our way and make sure that by our deeds, by our presentation, by our conduct, by our character, we are becoming disciples in whichever sphere of life that the Lord has placed you. Jesus requires of all of us to demonstrate love by our lifestyles. More than ever before, in this challenging time in Kenya, the whole world of COVID-19 and COVID pandemic, we can impact many by going out of our way and showing our love for all. And the promise and assurance from Jesus was and continues to be, I am with you always, with my Holy Spirit, to guide you, to lead you, and to show you how to be an effective discipler of the entire nation in this great commission. And I am reminded of an old chorus. He wants me to pray, to give and to go, that the whole world may know more about Jesus. This is service to the whole world. As we pray, as we give, the Lord wants us to go out of our way and become disciples. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for the key word, reminding us of how we ought to go and make the disciples. Almighty God, remember the whole world, our nation, and our families at this time, which is quite challenging because of this pandemic. We pray for those who are in isolation, those who are desperate and in hunger and in sickness, and those hit and hurt by the floods and even the landslide. We also do pray for the church, which is Christ's the head. Remember our Archbishop and his family, other bishops in different dioceses, and those in other denominations, and more specifically, our Lord Bishop Light Reverend Timothy and his family, and all those other clergy in the dioceses. We do pray for the nation, the presidency, and those in authority. Guide them, protect them, for we do pray this through your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we do pray.
Amen. Amen. And now the peace of God, which passes all understanding, will keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and the love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And now the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you, remain with you, now and forevermore. Amen. Jesus said,